In the previous video, we looked at some of the inner workings of animation in Smoke. Now let's deal with mixing multiple resolutions in the sequence. To do this, we use a timeline FX called Resize. If you have just joined and wish to follow along with the remaining lessons, you can download the media by clicking the link displayed in the YouTube description. If you are watching the podcast version of this lesson, just type the link displayed below in your internet browser to download the relevant media. An XML is included in the download so you can conform the sequence. Just follow the Getting Started Conform video if you need help to build the sequence. Smoke is resolution independent, which means your sequence can be any resolution you choose. You can also mix resolutions and frame rates in the same sequence, but all segments eventually conform to the sequence's settings. So if a source clip differs from the sequence by its physical frame size, bit depth, or frame interpretation, Smoke will apply a resize timeline FX to the relevant segments. This allows the mixed resolutions to be integrated into the sequence. For example, this sequence has a resolution of 1920 by 1080. In the media library, there is a source clip that is 3K by 2K. I'll select the source clip to load it into the source viewer. Press X to simultaneously mark the clip with in and out markers. I'll select the gap in the sequence and also press X to mark it up. Pressing the overwrite button or F10 edits the clip into the sequence. You'll see straight away that the new segment has a line indicator across the top of the segment. Selecting the segment shows a resize timeline effects in the effects pipeline. The basic parameters are also available for quick tweaking in the toolbar. Let's go into the effects editor and adjust the resize settings further. In the resize editor, the viewing area is split into two viewers. On the left is the original clip, and on the right is the result. Notice that the destination resolution is grayed out, but it is set to the resolution of the sequence. However, when performing compositing operations, you will have access to the original media and its full resolution. Normally, if you're scaling images of different sizes and aspect ratios, the settings you need to be concerned with is the type of resize and the image filtering. Let's start off with the resize types. You have four resize types or modes that you can use to adjust your image. The first mode to look at is center crop. This simply places the image in the center of the resize and is cropped if the image is larger than the resized frame. There is no scaling being applied to the original image. The second mode is letterbox. This mode will scale the longest edge of the original image to the resized frame. This is quite common if you had to place a 16x9 image in a 4x3 frame. The result image will be letterboxed top and bottom. The third mode is fill. This mode will take the entire original image and stretch it in all directions until every pixel completely fills the result frame. The fourth and final mode is crop edges. This mode works in combination with the bounding box seen in the original image viewer. You can also use the bounding box to isolate a specific portion of your image or perform a basic pan and scan movement. The image filtering is the quality of how Smoke scales the image. Lanczos is regarded as the best quality, and Impulse is regarded as draft or preview quality. Let's scale this large image to fit the result frame. I also want to specifically isolate a section of the image. You can zoom the viewer if necessary and set the resize mode to crop edges. Using the bounding box, you can quickly lock down the section you are after. As you have seen, all the settings are editable and most could be animated for added effect. When you exit the editor, your result is already in the sequence. Depending on your hardware, you might be able to preview it during playback. Once you are satisfied with the result, select the segment and press the render button. When the render is complete, you can review the result. Remember that you can always modify your settings as you continue working on your edit. In the next video, we'll delve into the world of color correction, as well as highlight a few good grading workflows.